Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Hollow Knight. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we continue making our way through the green path. We found Carnifer, we found a really deep voice monster, hunter guy. And today we're just going to continue on making our way through green path, explore as much as we can. And see where we end up. Don't want to drop down here. Yeah, sorry. It's a fair few enemies here. It's these vertical levels which are actually really difficult to navigate because, obviously, the main way you attack in this game is horizontally, rather than up and down. Like you can slash up and down, in a manner of speaking. Oh shit! I walked right into that one. You can slash up and down, manner of speaking, but that also brings gravity into the play rather than you being able to fully control where it is you're going. So that's why I think these vertical rooms are some of the hardest to navigate in the game. But we always make do. It's just like essentially the similar to Super Metroid. Although with Super Metroid, you're more... Where am I? I don't want to go up. I want to see if I can get down to that bench. Although with Super Metroid, you've got projectile attacks, which help you out in terms of up and down. Like you don't have to jump to hit things. Well, you don't in this game in a way because you've got your soul ability, which shoots. It's called Vengeful Spirit, I think. The one which shoots the soul out to enemies and kills them. Because we've got that in this game. God, swing it, it tapers. Because you got that in this game, but that's not like an infinite resource. You're going to be wasting soul if you just use that constantly. Right, see what's down here then. There's a little toe booth here. And yes, this game does this, if you inspect. It will charge you to come into this area. So if I give up 50 Geo, it'll unlock the gates and let me sit on this bench. And let's take a look at our map. As you can see, that room there on the towards the middle, where it sort of fades away, that's the dark room that I didn't want to venture forth into. But we've made such progress in the green path. That's crazy. Is this the sort of like the second and a half episode we've been in the green path, isn't it? Oh, that was a bit of a disaster right there. I just fell down into this place, which I'm not sure I really want to be in. Oh god, you're freaking spawning right when I want to get some money. There we go. Let's get all this geo. And the next thing I'll be doing before I do anything else, well, I need to get to a... I hope there's a stack station around here somewhere. There might be. I hope so. But before I do too much, I want to go back to Dirtmouth and buy new things. Maybe some new charms, maybe some new things on the map. Yeah, I'll get some of my soul back. Yeah, and it looks like those things only give you 33 soul back. So, 1/3 of your soul meter. They're not like almighty soul full replenishers or anything. They just recharge your soul when you need an extra charge or something. So, let's see what's over here. There's a lot of spikes around here. It's starting to look a bit more nastier than the rest of the world, I suppose. A lot less hospitable. What's this say? From moss and leaf our life is drawn. While it grows upon the path, we shall never wilt. Huh. So is that referring to the enemies or these spike tendrils or something? Saying that because this area is so mossy, we're never going to die. Right, this is an area where can't do the platforming, unfortunately, so we'll just move on to the next area, which is up here, I believe. Indeed it is. Let's see what's up here. Hopefully nothing too nasty. Ah, so you have a Venus flytrap. Or whatever it's called. I could figure out what it's called, actually, if I just go to the Hunter's Journal. Let's do that, actually. Fool Eater. Ha! 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 Yeah, because if you get snapped at it, you're kind of a fool, apparently. Oh shit, I can't come this way. I've got to go over top and back down because that lever will open this gate here, so there's nothing I can do here. So let's just go back to where I was before. So there's not much traveling I need to do, so I'll not get anything out. But I'm essentially going back to that bench and then reascending that room. I would start debating whether or not I need to cut this stuff out, because you've seen me go up this place, go up and down this place before. You don't need to see me do it 1,000 times to essentially get to where I need to be. Rude, freaking shooting me. In fact, we'll load our map up with what I've just explored down there. Yep, perfect. And one thing that I think is funny about, well, I say funny, but strange about this game is that it doesn't matter what, how much you've explored a room. If you've been in the room, it will just populate it with. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That was a disaster. It'll just fill up on the map with the room that you've completed. So, like, you see that tall room to the left of me? I only went to the bottom of that room, but it's already fully painted. I guess that might make it too easy to find things that are hidden. You won't have to rely on your memory if you know exactly where you've been. Like, there could be areas in a room that you've not explored. But if it's already painted on a map, then you'll never know. These things can be a pain. There you go. Do I need to worry about this guy? This is where I came in, isn't it? Yeah, I don't need to go that way. Okay, I'll try and avoid that guy. I don't have to unnecessarily engage enemies and take off health if I can avoid it. What? Excuse me. See, I'm not sure what these are supposed to be. They're like... not obbles. Moskins. A volatile moskin. Yeah. So there's sort of like a different bug that's specific to these mossy areas then, I suppose. But it's supposed to be humid. I don't see why they'd have a woolly coat. What do I know? I don't... What's up here? Just a sign. The greater mind once dreamed of leaf and cast these caverns so. In every bush, in every vine, the mind of Un reveals itself to us. I wonder what this Un entity is that it keeps mentioning. It's almost like some kind of god. Seeing it as in. I don't want to go that way just yet. I want to float over to the left first and foremost. And just have a quick explore around what's in here. Because I know what's in that room to the right. Damn. Well, I can't get over there anyway. Unless I do some sick jump. No, I can't. Right, so it looks like I am heading off to the right. And this is good. This might be a risk, but we'll give it a go. Hello. There we go. Ah, yeah, it's just like another one of those mini boss. I'm not actually sure what it's called. I think it's a moss knight. There you go. It's sort of like a higher level of bug that you face in this area. And whilst this guy doesn't necessarily drop anything, it essentially unlocks the this particular area to you, which you can use to navigate back around. And one thing I really appreciate about this game is it always. After you've done a mini boss like that, you think like, oh, the game should give me a reprieve. I should have a whole area not filled with enemies because I worked hard. This game doesn't do that. It's like, yeah, you face the boss, but this place is still filled with horrible things that are trying to kill you. And I appreciate it does that. It stays true to the formula of the game that they've made. They wanted it to be challenging. They didn't want it to be just a series of boss battles. It's a constant fight getting through this game. And having to deal with all these enemies. Alright, so let's see what's to the right here. Is there anything in particular? Other than just resources for money. That's the way I came up. Let's just see what's over here. I don't necessarily think I want to be spending too much time in here. This seems like a whole new area. Spikes and stuff, which I fell into. Yeah, I don't want to be messing around in here too much. I don't think there's anything in there for me at the moment. So I'll instead stick to the green path and navigate back over here. Get away from me, you jerk. Right. Where am I at the moment? Let's see what's over here. This is where I came back. I'm supposed to be going left here. Fantastic. It's easy to get disorientated sometimes with these multiple platforms. Hello. What are you chewing on him for? Oh, I missed every shot. Okay, you just gotta be careful here, because this guy tends to... Yeah, it's kind of hard to avoid. It's kind of hard to hit him. I think this is where you've got to really use your... your vertical abilities. Oh, shit. I'll take the damage on that one. So I got a hit in, essentially. There we go. That was actually a really decent boss fight, to be honest. First time I came across that guy, struggled because he's one of those guys that tends to stay away. Oh, it's too, oh god, I thought I killed him by accident. It's one of those bosses that tries to stay away and then lunges at you so he can't get a hit in. So I think that was managed pretty well. Bacala.
Just what do you think you're doing? You dare to come between me and my prey? Is it a habit of yours to scurry about getting in the way and causing bother? Novice cur, I am Zote the Mighty, a knight of great renown. Cross me again and you'll find out why they call my weapon Life Ender.
Dude, I saved your ass.
What are you still bothering me for? I'm a knight. I'm not interested in your childish games. I need my rest. Be gone! Lest I draw my nail.
Yeah, sort of a cocky guy. Saved his ass, because clearly he had that handle, didn't he? Saves his ass, and then no thanks at all. Just claims all credit for it or whatever. Right, so I am here. Is that the jump I couldn't make? No, there's a knight down there. Don't want to face him if I don't have to. Whoa, sneak. I wasn't expecting him to come out of there. Okay, let me just get some soul charge off this thing, actually. Okay, now I need to be careful because I'm taking a bit of damage here and I've got no soul to replenish my health. I do now, so I'll get that back as best as I can. And just have a nosy on, see what's over here. Plenty of these things, aren't there? What are they guarding? And we'll get that final chunk of health. What are you guarding over here? A little notice. The green children walked from the dream onto these lands. Here we now shall wait, patient for the call to return. I'm not sure what to make of this lore. I'm not sure how to piece it all together, to be honest. Let's just drop down here. And do I want to drop down here? I think I do. Okay. Just that I'm conscious that I'll not be able to get back up there. There's that guy there, but... Hello. Right, there we go. Oh, apologies for the lack of commentary during those high focus moments, but it's good to feel the intensity as I'm concentrating. So that's why I'm not really doing post commentary, to cover the gaps with that. I just think it's better to have intense moments when the moments are intense, you know. Like, if I go in here, I think there's two of them. Pottering about. So I'm not sure I want to necessarily just jump in there willy-nilly. Yeah, there's two. There's one there. So if I drop down, I might be able to deal with them one at a time. There we go, it's that guy, and there is another one down there, but he's laying dormant at the moment. Hello. You're getting too much money for me to ignore you at the moment, friend. So, unfortunately, you must now die. Okay. Oh shit, I fell for that one. There we go. Cool. And look at how much money we got out of this deal. We've got like nearly 1,000 geo now. That's crazy. Right. So I've faced those guys down. We've come through here. Let me just get that health back. And we'll continue navigating our way downwards, I think. Don't necessarily go... Well, can't really go upwards, can we? It's just sort of like a... one of those rooms where it's like horizontal and vertical. Okay, so that means I can now get back up here, which is... Oh god, you sneaked up on me, Jesus. Crafty bastard. Yeah, screw you. Give me your money. Right, what way do I want to go? I don't think I want to go left just yet. I want to follow this sign, because that sign means there's a stag station, so... that's a very nice sign to be following. Okay, what's this direction? Oh, it's just this is where I dropped that block. So let's go see if there's a stack station down here and follow this sign. Very useful at the moment. Because that means I'll be able to get back to Dirtmouth and purchase some things. Right, look at that sweet map, yo. Nearly explored the entire area. That's fantastic. Right, but I think we need to pay a toll here. Yes. And then we'll ring the bell and we'll call the stag. The Bat Stag! With his deep, throaty voice. See what he's got to say about this place. My, this place is much changed since I last saw it. The green it grows so wild, the stations like to be consumed by it. There you go. Right, so to Dirtmouth, and I'm gonna end this episode off by purchasing a few things. So let's just quickly get up to the shops. All right, let's speak to Sly.
Oh, come on, yeah.
Oh, he's just gonna say the same thing, isn't he? Let's have a see what he sells. The mass shard vessel fragments. I'm not too fussed about at the moment, because I'm not gonna get enough fragments to essentially make a complete one. I'll explain that as we start getting more. Items which will essentially complete a set there.
Morbidis.
Of all the places to end up, we've picked this dreary town. I'd fought at a temporary stop when my husband became obsessed with that old ruin. Now he's spending all his time down there. He argues cartography is sound business, but other than you, who's buying?
I don't know.
People should be buying because it's really useful. Right, okay, let's get some of this stuff. So, I'll get the vendor pins, because that could turn out to be useful. And the hot spring pin. Do I need anything else? I'll just keep purchasing things, because I need them. A cocoon pin. Right, and then I'll just quickly double check if there's anything I can buy from Sly, because I don't want to carry around 400 geo, if I can avoid it. Okay, I'll buy this mask shard from him. And I'll explain about those as we start getting more, but... As you can see, it starts filling up an image there. And once you get four, you get an extra hit point essentially at the top of your screen there. And that's all come back. Yes, we'll buy a rancid egg. Just so I've got it. Excellent. And unless our old friend the Elderbug's got anything new to say. Yeah, it just explains about the fungal growth. We're going to end it here, and next episode we'll continue exploring the green path. I think we've explored pretty much everything we can, to be honest. So we'll go up to that room on the left and see what happens. So thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.